On paper, the Galaxy Z Flip 7 comes with a lot of compromises compared to the S25 Ultra, like the lack of a telephoto lens, no S Pen, and more bezels on the screen. But it has some fun features that no other phone has. It also debuts the Exynos 2500 chipset, which we don't have much information about yet, and we will be putting that into the test. The question is, does the form factor overcome those compromises or not? Hello, this is Mo. Welcome to Tecmo. And today we are going to compare the Galaxy Z Flip 7 versus the Galaxy S25 Ultra. The Flip does flip, of course, and Ultra is also the best that Samsung is offering right now. The Galaxy Z Flip 7 comes in two variations, the Z Flip 7 and the Z Flip 7 FE. In this video, we are focusing on the standard variant, which has a larger cover screen and an Exynos 2500 instead of the Exynos 2400 chipset. The Z Flip 7 compared to the Z Flip 6 and the Z Flip 7 FE has a larger cover display, as you can see here, and that's a very nice and welcome change. It is now 4.1 inches. The inner display almost has no crease anymore and is now 6.9 inches, which is the exact size of the Galaxy S25 Ultra. On the back of the phone, you have the classic two camera setup, and of course, the phone folds. The Galaxy S25 Ultra also has a 6.9 inch display, but it's wider than the Flip. It is more durable with a titanium frame and has a four camera setup with two extra telephoto lenses compared to the Flip. One interesting thing I noticed is that it is actually better to watch short videos on the Z Flip compared to the Ultra, since your content won't be cut off on the sides. Both displays have a 120Hz refresh rate and offer a nice, contrasty look with punchy colors. The Z Flip has a fingerprint scanner on the side, while the S25 Ultra has an ultrasonic under-display fingerprint scanner. The S25 Ultra, though, is anti-reflective, and that's one of the features that might convince you to go for that instead of the Z Flip, especially if you go outside often and don't live in Netherlands, so you actually see the sun from time to time. The Flip's cover screen is very useful if you want to take a glance at the weather or check your daily brief. And with more and more people chatting with Gemini, the cover screen can be even more useful since it does support that too, though you can't run every single app on it. Most Flip users that I know, including Nina, heavily use the cover screen when taking pictures and videos. Also, because of the form factor, you can leave your phone on the table without needing a tripod. That's super nice if you're a content creator or a TikToker and want to record yourself often. It also makes the phone feel quirky and unique, and you can use it like a webcam when filming. But the main advantage of this form factor is that you'll get the best selfies out there, since you can use the cover screen as a viewfinder and use the main camera instead of the selfie camera.
When deciding between those two phones, it's maybe important to note that this one, as we've already mentioned, has a better camera. Like, it has a bigger sensor, so it takes in more stuff. But for this one, you can do more creative shots if you want to, like this one.
When taking photos with the main lens, the Z Flip is less contrasty and also has less background blur due to the smaller sensor size. The S25 Ultra, on the other hand, is more contrasty with punchier colors, less magenta, and overall looks closer to how Nina actually looks, as you can see in the middle picture taken by my Sony camera. Generally, the S25 Ultra's colors are more saturated. That could also be due to the software differences, since the Ultra is now running One UI 7, while the Z Flip is on One UI 8, and they're also using different chipsets. Let's test the video with the main lens and hear Nina's experience with the Flip phones. Nina, we collectively have a question. Why do you have a Flip?
I was walking around the store and I was like, damn, I need a new phone because I wanted a new phone for some of the games I play. I was like, damn, there is this really gimmicky one, and I saw some TikToks about it. And I was like, damn, it's like spec-wise, it's like worse than, for example, S24 or like the 24 Ultra or something, from what I know. But like, you can do like this and then make pictures with it. And I just love it for the gimmick because it fits my personality in a way. And I also like that you can make it like small and just have the screen.
Both of them can shoot in log, and after color grading, the Z Flip's footage is interestingly less contrasty and has a vibe that feels more like a normal camera, which I see as a positive. The S25 Ultra's colors might be a bit punchier after color grading with Samsung's official lot, and here I actually prefer the Flip's default colors. They both also have an ultra-wide lens, with the Ultra having a 50-megapixel sensor with a larger sensor, while the Z Flip still uses an outdated 12-megapixel one. You can see that the S25 Ultra generally handles ultra-wide shots better. For example, if we zoom in here, the Z Flip's image is noticeably softer compared to the Ultra, which is expected. Also, you can take macro shots with the ultra-wide lens on the Galaxy S25 Ultra, but you can't do that with the Z Flip 7. But the biggest difference in the camera system, in my opinion, is the lack of a telephoto lens on the Flip. That means if you zoom more than 3 times into a subject, like I did here, the S25 Ultra takes a much better photo. And if you zoom in even more, like 5 times, where the S25 Ultra switches to the better telephoto lens, the difference becomes even more noticeable. This is one of the Flip's main disadvantages. I really hope Samsung at least adds a better main 200-megapixel camera on the Flip, so when it crops it while zooming, it retains more detail. And obviously, for 5x zoom videos, you can also clearly see the quality difference between the Z Flip and the S25 Ultra. The Z Flip can only zoom up to 10 times, while the S25 Ultra can zoom up to 30 times here, and even up to 100 times, letting you take photos of things you can barely see with your own eyes. The selfie camera is where the Z Flip really shines, though, because you can use the main camera. You get better overall quality on the Flip. The reason Nina is blurred here is that the main camera has a larger sensor, so for group pictures, it might actually be better to use the regular selfie camera on the Flip so everyone is in focus, like I did here. Also, fun fact, one of the reasons the picture colors differs between the Z Flip and the S25 Ultra is because of the chipset difference. The image signal processing ISP in the chipset handles a lot of that color processing, which brings me to the hot topic of Exynos versus a Snapdragon. So the Galaxy Z Flip 7 has the Exynos 2500 versus the S25 Ultra has the Snapdragon 8 Elite. We can't really compare these two with each other because they have a different form factor. For example, the Flip is slimmer, whereas the Galaxy S25 Ultra is thicker. Also, it has a larger vapor chamber. But nevertheless, I know a lot of you are here to see if Exynos is on par with the Snapdragon 8 Elite. To test that, I ran a few benchmarks. I'm also running the application I wrote on the right side to check the battery temperature of the phones. But a quick disclaimer, the Flip phones historically always have a higher temperature regardless of the chipset due to the laws of thermodynamics and their compact form factor. In the Geekbench test, the Z Flip scored around 700 points less compared to the custom-made Snapdragon 8 Elite on the S25 Ultra. On the multi-core level 2, the Exynos got only 7,700, while the Snapdragon reached 9,600. Then I ran Antutu. Antutu is a more comprehensive benchmark since it tests many components, not just the CPU. It also evaluates memory and GPU performance. In this test, the Exynos 2500 scored around 1.58 million, while the S25 Ultra got around 2.2 million. The Ultra performed better in both CPU and GPU, while interestingly, the Z Flip had a higher memory score. What that means in practical terms is, if you do tasks like video editing or gaming, the performance of the S25 Ultra or any phone with a Snapdragon 8 Elite is better, while the Exynos 2500 is slightly behind. But if you are doing something like exporting media in CapCut, which is more memory intensive, as I did here, the Z Flip 7 with Exynos actually finished the export faster than the S25 Ultra. That said, both phones are butterly smooth when it comes to productivity and daily tasks. As long as you are not gaming or editing videos heavily, you don't need to worry about performance. Battery life is another concern for some users, since historically, Exynos hasn't been as power efficient as a Snapdragon. Also, the Flip 7 has a 4,300 mAh battery, While the S25 Ultra has 5000 mAh. That's why I did a day-in-the-life battery test. After around 3.5 hours of screen on time with heavy usage, including some gaming, a lot of camera work, which you just saw, and watching YouTube, while both phones were connected to the same 5G network, the Flip ended up with 47% battery and the Ultra with 51%. So at least in this test, it doesn't seem like the Exynos is draining more battery. I think Samsung may have simply reduced the performance of the chipset slightly to counter any potential battery drain. Also, Nina told me she once dropped the phone and everything was broken, but luckily the phone was insured. Fold and flip phones are generally more fragile compared to the slab phones, so I do recommend always getting a store insurance or Samsung Care.
Except for the screen feeling like it's kind of fragile or something, and getting scratched more easily from what I know, but when you put it in your bag, you can fold it, so... I've only had good experiences with it. I mean, I know the camera is a bit worse, but I don't mind that because, like, when I want to take pictures, I can set it up like this, and then that's, like, for me, that is a trade-off where I say, yeah, this is worth it.
So would I overall recommend the Galaxy Z Flip? If you are into flips, I think it's the best flip that's ever built by Samsung. Also, the cover screen is much larger, which is very nice, but you should also know the downside of the flip. For example, you have a worse camera compared to the Samsung Galaxy S25 Ultra. The chipset is the Exynos 2500, which is not as good as the Snapdragon 8 Elite. And also the battery life, even though they put a larger battery capacity, is still not as good as the Galaxy S25 Ultra. If you're okay with this kind of compromises, yes, the Galaxy Z Flip can be a great choice, for example, for Nina. If you enjoyed this video, you can also check out the comparison between the Galaxy S25 Ultra and the Z Fold 7 next. Thanks for tuning in to Tecmo, and I will see you in the next one.